I think Rachmaninoff's second piano concerto is just filled with gorgeous melodies, one after another, and it really does start right from the beginning. It's a very dramatic start to the concerto. Rachmaninoff was coming out of deep depression with these chords from the darkest place in his life, and then he somehow comes back and rolls out this gorgeous melody, and it's really like he's conquered his insecurities and the voices that tell him he can't. So I think this beginning is very significant in that in his life and in his repertoire. So it starts like this. I don't get to play the first melody. It roars from the string section, but I get to play eight measures alone that that pushes the orchestra to start playing one of the greatest melodies. So here are the chords. This, the strings come in and play the C minor melody, which really, yeah, grows out of these F minor chord that starts a C minor concerto. It's very, that's the last thing I tell myself before I go on stage. And it only brings us to a very contrasting melody that I get to introduce. And it just goes on. And I think one thing about Rachmaninoff melodies is that it's timeless. You never really know where a singer would breathe if they were to sing a Rachmaninoff melody, because it's just it's interwoven with so much nostalgia. You never know when it's the middle of the sentence or you're just simply taking time to because you need it, because it's such an emotional melody. I think you'd be glad to know that in the second movement, the melodies you'll hear were not inspired by pop music, but the other way around. I think you'll maybe be reminiscent of Celine Dion's All By Myself, which I think really grows out of this melody. Especially those days are gone. This melody is being played with clarinet playing the accompaniment, and we take turns singing this this melody. I get to accompany sometimes, and then the clarinet accompanies the piano. Third movement also filled with fabulous melodies. I think no one would see the piano entrance coming. The third movement sort of it starts off from absolutely the most pianissimo point in at the end of the second movement. And then piano sits there. I gather my thoughts, and the first thing I play is... So that's my beginning to the third movement, and it really, I do have to concentrate quite a bit because it goes from one extreme to the other. And if you have had fallen asleep in the second movement, I think you'll definitely wake up with the exciting start of the third movement.